My name is Kody Harris. I'm from Lansing, Michigan, and I'm a farrier. A farrier is someone who shoes horses, trims their feet, helps out at times, if able, with any problems with their gaits, or if sometimes infections or other pathologies we can lend a hand with. An equine healthcare professional. I don't think being... I don't think being a farrier is for everyone. It definitely takes a certain kind of person. If you want to be a farrier, you have to have a big work ethic. You have to be dedicated to it. It's a lot of hours of repetition and a lot of learning. And so you definitely have to have a bigger picture in mind for the long term. It's not something you do 9 to 5. Being a farrier is much more of a way of living. You don't walk away from it. Everything you do is tied in with your profession. Maybe the next day you're shoeing a horse, and the evening before you build a pair of shoes for it, and you know sort of from memory what the horse's feet are like, so you're thinking ahead to the next day in preparation for it. And then maybe in the evening you're taking care of your tools, maybe changing the brakes on your truck, preparing for the next day. So yeah, it's a lifestyle. There's a huge need for farriers. I would say the horse population in the United States was probably at its lowest right after World War II. That's when more and more of the farmers, probably the majority of farmers, started using tractors, other motorized vehicles, and the workhorse kind of became obsolete. And so I would say for about 15 or 20 years, there's probably very few farriers. But in the 1960s or so, the horse started becoming more of a recreation animal, and folks started just riding them for pleasure. And horse shows became very popular, and parades and whatnot. There's definitely more horses than I could ever shoe. I started off following my dad around. He was a farrier before I was born. And so just going around to a couple different farms, hobby farms mostly, and watching what he did, handing him tools. And then after I graduated high school, I went to Heartland Horseshoeing School down in Lamar, Missouri. And that's where I got my start. I enjoy driving through the countryside, meeting folks. I love working with animals. Knowing that I can make a difference, and even in a small way, with some horses to make them more comfortable or something like that. And also, I guess, being sole proprietor of a business, you know that your living comes from what you do with your own hands. That's always very rewarding. The most challenging thing is that every horse is unique, every horse is different, and of course the anatomy is going to be the same with every horse, but each individual horse's need is a little bit different. And so being able to know what a horse needs and having the knowledge and experience to apply that is very challenging at times. I don't really have a slogan for the work that I do, but always, I guess from the beginning, even going to school, I always had a verse from Colossians in mind. Colossians 3:23, and whatever you do, do it wholeheartedly as unto the Lord and not for men. And so that's kind of where my work ethic originates from, and that's what I strive for in all that I do. And when I'm trimming, when I'm shoeing horses, and then also beyond.